Let's talk about Black Cake on Hulu. Hit the like and subscribe button as the intro plays. All right, so instantly I was intrigued when I saw that a show called Black Cake was coming on Hulu. Why? Because Black people were involved.
I'm rooting for everybody Black.
And it wasn't going to be a gangster thug story or some trauma story. Well, it is a trauma story, but the way it's told isn't your typical trauma story that we often see in regards to Black people on television, because that's by design, but we're not going to go there.
I keeps it real like that.
All right. So the story is about a lady named Eleanor. And up front in the movie, we see scenes of Eleanor swimming. But so we then see Eleanor in the present moment, you know, by the shore of the surfboard. But Eleanor, we find out instantly, is dying. She has a fall. Then she finds out she has a tumor and she dies.
Does your character die? In the script?
No.
Then it's a good script.
And her son is there, and he's basically on the phone with his sister saying, "Mom's okay, you don't have to come." All right, right then and there, I know, you know, something's afoot, because why are you telling your sister that your mom's okay and she doesn't have to come? So we know that there's gonna be some drama there.
But wait! There's more.
So then, you know, mom dies, funeral's had, the sister comes with her nose ring, and she comes, and she's obviously, you know, some tension between her and her brother, but then they kind of embrace, they're okay. So basically, a family friend, aka Preach.
Oh, baby, you make my heart bleed for you.
From Cooley High, aka Colonel Taylor, real name Glenn Turman, is a family friend attorney, and he promised their mom that he would make them sit down and listen to her life story, because apparently their mom never told them anything about her past. She always said she had no roots.
They're lying. Just lying.
So basically they were like, it was a back and forth. Oh, do we have to wait around for her? Can I just get this over with? So they get together and they listen to the video. I mean, they listen to the recordings that the mother did. My question is, when was she doing these recordings? Okay. When did the lady with the brain tumor do these recordings telling her kids the truth about her life? See, this is the production person in me. The continuity person in me. Y'all need to make this story make a little bit more sense.
Now, my position is this.
But I already said to myself, when everything happened so fast with the mom dying, that I'm going to have to release my expectations of this and just watch it for pure entertainment. Because a lot of times that's what I do. When I realize that a script isn't going to be good and the acting might not be the best, or the directorial choices aren't well done, I'm just going to either not watch it or watch it and release my expectations. So that's what I did. So basically, you know, as the story starts on the flash drive, which I think is a cheesy mnemonic to like tell the story on a flash drive. Let me plug this into my computer so y'all can hear. Wait a minute. Hold on. Let me get it straight. Let me get my video player going. All right. Here we go. I want to tell you the story of my life.
Mama Young, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready, she is.
My name is Coventina. Did she tell him that up front? I don't know. But when the story starts in Jamaica, we see Covey swimming. She's in a race and she wins the race. And her father is there, which we find out is a Chinese Jamaican. And a little about me, I'm Chinese Jamaican. No, I'm not. I actually went to college with some Chinese Jamaicans. That was my first time. This was many, 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 many moons ago. And Howard University, shout out, School of Architecture. I was in class with this Chinese Jamaican guy, and he was hilarious. He used to make me laugh, and because he was so dry and he had the Jamaican accent, and then every time I would look at him, I'm like, Chinese, Jamaican, Chinese, Jamaican.
To grow up in Jamaica.
And it always tickled me that he had that accent. And the other thing is, my favorite Jamaican spot that I used to eat at every single day for 4 years. I'm not even lying. I'm not exaggerating. I may have missed maybe 3 days of not eating at this spot. Was run by Chinese Jamaicans. And they would always play in the store. Dear, dear, dear. Hit me like a fresh vegetable. Okay, back to the story.
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Chinese Jamaicans. So I'm happy that this is a Chinese Jamaican story. So, Covey is a teenager. She looked like a 12-year-old, but she's a teenager. And into teenage things, i.e. boys. Because Covey and her friend Bunny go to the beach and they look off into the distance and they see this guy and they're like, oh, I know you like his long board.
Has a one-eyed brown snake.
That's no snake, honey.
And I was like, ooh, sexual innuendos early on. But no, this guy named Gibbs was holding a long surfboard and Gibbs was going to teach Covey how to surf. So, you know, Covey promised Bunny, her friend, you know, I'll be back. We're going to practice. We are going to train because we got to get off this island. I always wonder, like, why do people want to get off the island who are from the island? The islands are beautiful. Like, you want to come here? Like, why you want to come to the U.S.? It's not beautiful and it's more expensive, but to each his own. There are many island people everywhere. So Gibbs and Covey go into the water. And here's a continuity thing, everybody. So, you know, Covey falls, blah, blah, blah. Then Gibbs and Covey decide to swim away to Lover's Rock. For the reggae fans, you know what Lover's Rock is. That's what I'm calling it, Lover's Rock. They swim over there to this cave, rocky area. But my question is, what happened to the surfboard?
I ain't got to tell you what happened next.
Surfboard. What happened to the surfboard? Y'all just gonna leave a surfboard out there? I thought this was your thing, Gibbs. So anyhow, they go. And then a storm is coming. I gotta get back to train before the storm comes, Gibbs. I love you, but I gotta get back to Bunny. So they get back and storm comes. So I'm not gonna go through every single frame of the show. But I'm just setting up that Covey had a man that her father did not want her with. Because just like most men who have daughters, they don't want their daughter's innocence to be taken away.
The patriarchy?
Or their dreams to be taken away by, i.e. sex. Because sex comes babies. And then, you know, whatever, whatever. But Covey, being a ballsy girl, was like, look, Gibbs, I'm gonna sneak around with you, okay? F what my daddy says. He just a gambling old Chinese man anyhow. And my mama left my daddy. And I forgot to tell that. The story kind of opens up with Covey's mom and dad on the island. And the mother was a beautiful chocolate woman. And the way the camera and lighting was hitting her skin, it was just beautiful. It gave me the whole island thing, it was a vibe. It took me someplace.
Come back to Jamaica.
Come back to gentility.
I like shows that take me places, all right? I like tropical settings. So if you want to win me over, have a tropical setting show. Anyhow, so fast forward to the father's a gambler. And he owes the Sharks money. Lil' Man. Why is the gangster's name Lil' Man? That's not intimidating. Like, his name, he's not like Sweet Daddy Williams from Good Times, the Long Short. Now, that's an intimidating name.
JJ, my man. You in trouble.
His name is Lil Man. So anyhow, Lil Man basically approaches Covey. So you could tell the Lil Man had his eye on Covey, and was just really cringy because he was clearly older than Covey. So basically, the father owed money. And so basically, was going to pay off his debt by selling Covey to Little Man. So Covey had to marry Little Man. But guess what? On their wedding day, wedding night, at the reception where they were playing the lover's rock music and dancing with the horns, Little Man dropped dead.
Damn!
So instantly, Covey took off. And she booked and jumped into that ocean and went to swimming. And Bunny knew, Bunny's her best friend, knew where she was. So she and her housekeeper, who I forgot to mention, who had been there since her mother left, had been there since day one, been taking care of Covey since Covey's mother left the family, basically came with like, look, this is your new name. Forget your past. You got to get out of here. And she had to get on a boat and she left. So that's pretty much episode one. Her name is no longer Coventina, whatever it was. It's now Coventina Brown. And I'm thinking, Coventina Brown, that's not too different than your regular name. Like, for real. So, she meets her roommate, Eleanor. Catch. Wait a minute, who's Eleanor? Stay tuned. And that's what I like about the show. Each episode has a little cliffhanger that makes you want to watch more. Because the action within the episode isn't necessarily actioning, but the cliffhanger makes you want to go to the next episode. So stay tuned. I'm going to come back for maybe episode 2, 3, 4, 5, because it took me forever to do episode 1. And imagine if I tried to do episode 1 through 4. So we'll see what happens next. All right, like and subscribe and drop into the comments and tell me what you thought about Black Cake.